My name is Puneesh Srivastava.
Arvind Susarla.
Ashok Ghosh.
Dr. Arunabha Majumdar.
I am Dr. T.N. Guha Majumdar.
Hi, I am Chandan Mahantar.
I work with HSBC Bank and I manage the environment and climate change portfolio for the bank in India.
We solve complex and tough behavioral problems in social and commercial sectors.
I'm also a member of the Task Force of ASEAN Corporate Office Bengal.
The fact that arsenic as a water pollutant has been a recent discovery and acknowledgement is something very grave, because its impact has been there for a long time and the population who has been affected because of late recognition is concerning.
Arsenic produces severe human health hazards like pigmentation and keratosis and arsenic related lung disease, liver fibrosis and also nervous system affections and peripheral neuropathy.
But we are still not sure what kind of water we are supplying, both from microbial perspective as far as surface water goes, and that is why there is a great deal of dependency even now on the groundwater.
Perhaps there is a need to kind of look at arsenic as a socially produced risk, because what's happening increasingly is there are so many elements in nature that has all kinds of effects on us. The risk comes when there are certain human activities create that, and I think that is where the problem is, because the whole concentration of where arsenic occurs, the geology of it and all, drives the point away from action.
I mean, the incidence of information gap about the sector, about the problem, about the solutions which are available is huge.
If you look at arsenic, that it takes something like 7 years for symptoms to build up. Now, it's a huge communication challenge, because I'm communicating something today, but after which you're going to see the effects in the future.
The biggest problem is the problem of technology transfer.
All water contaminants like fluorine or arsenic always have their gravest impact on people who have access to less nutrition or people who are malnourished.
Can we think of a new way of approaching as to how we are framing it and how are we tackling it?
We need to pick messages that are simpler, for example. And number two, that's something that has an impact that day.
All this knowledge which is present there in a fragmented way needs to be activated. When I say activated, there needs to be, you know, put on a platform which is easily accessible and in a form which is easily usable and, you know, comprehensible by all stakeholders, common people, NGOs, grassroots organizations, research organizations and also policy makers.
So extremely complex and multidimensional problems are very difficult to address, and very often one good way of addressing them, challenging them, is through networks, because networks amplify voices from the ground, networks add volumes, networks give immense reach, and they also bring in multiplicity of voices and multiplicity of strategies.
It is a complex problem, it's a wicked problem, it needs lots of different players to play out their parts. So we felt that the best thing to do perhaps would be to actually follow a network approach.
If people come together on a platform, how each one takes an idea, an agenda into their own work. So that cumulatively adds tremendous strength in terms of innovation capacity of the system, or outputs at the individual level, or outputs that contribute to the agenda.
इस नेटवर्क को हम चाहते हैं कि एक ऐसा नेटवर्क हो कि जो स्थानीय स्तर पर आर्सेनिक से मुद्दे जो भर कर आ रहे हैं उसको एक बड़े पैमाने पर शेयर किया जाए और वहाँ की जो सोल्यूशन की बात है उसके लिए एक छोटा सा प्रयास किया जाए.
वॉट इज इट्स स्ट्रेंथ इज ऑल्सो इट्स वीकनेस, बिकॉज देर आर डाइवर्स प्लेयर्स, देर आर डाइवर्स ग्रुप ऑफ एक्टर्स, there are diverse issues, right? Water, health, nutrition, multiplicity of institutions involved in it, either at the government level as well as the NGOs or on the health space. So how do you reconcile voices? How do you resolve conflicts? How do you still go ahead and make sure that you can come to a coherent outcome?
what a lot of research publications, nearly about 50 on the arsenic health hazard and also its management, its clinical treatment, and also how to have this mitigation in village level. And this whole host of scientific literature will be available to the network.
By providing the technology which is considered to me is feasible for the rural areas, vis-a-vis economically viable technology. It should be a low-cost technology, no doubt. I have to give certain technology which can be developed in the villages, means by the local artisan, local support, local skill, local infrastructure. They can manufacture filters, arsenic removal units at a low cost. This could be given to the villagers through weekly heart, that is market, through social marketing.
Have shared its own experiences of the projects in various states of India, expanding the reach of this network and the knowledge network particularly to the local organizations in different states, as well as through them to the communities where the problem is.
That we are doing a lot of interesting research in the core sediment, where we are looking at the solid phase and the liquid partitioning. And I guess we also have things to tell the world, that some of these studies are pretty new in nature. Hopefully in the long run, the network could be a platform to share this knowledge with others as well.
I have a very strong database about arsenic affected area in Bihar, and hopefully I'll be in position to give you some technology.
This platform can be leveraged in a big way, probably to inform policy making, and that way we can, you know, contribute towards a bigger change, a long term one.
It is important to set out tangible, achievable goals initially and achieve them and inspire people to keep carrying on.